right, moving along here. All right, this gentleman. All right, our good friend Don opens at the Golden Nugget in Las Vegas for a week starting the 1st of March, and then he'll be at Harrah's in Lake Tahoe March the 7th. Would you welcome Mr. Warmth, Don Rickles? Knock it off over there.
Don't be that way. I haven't been on in 30 years.
Will you milk me?
You know, 30 years, I mean...
Well, you used up most of your time bowing.
Well, okay. I've
never seen anybody milk an audience like that, I mean...
Would you talk a little louder?
I believe you, too. And you may be right. I don't know anymore.
Hey,
you're
both the same age. Don't knock it.
Well, we're moving along.
That's
we're moving
right.
along.
Ed, you look great.
Thank you, sir.
Oh.
we'll clear this up right away. What's new?
Every time my wife opens the paper, she said, Ed's in the paper.
That's right.
I said, what is he doing? Printing it? What is he doing?
Been very active the past few months.
I'm happy for
Thank you, sir.
And everything's going to work out.
Thank you very much.
You're going to be broke, but it's going to work out. And he's laughing like he collected a fortune. I'm sitting between two guys that went...
Okay, sure.
They did. I love you. I got a little Jewish lady just lays in the house that goes, you owe me nothing.
Except jewelry. That's what you think. All right, now,
thank you.
Nice to
you. Let's clear that up. I must say, both of you guys, I haven't been on in quite some time.
Yes.
Because Freddie told me you didn't want humor. And it's good to be back with you. Both of you are good friends. And yeah. Why don't we, we're the Musketeers, why don't we go back to the old days in the Copacabana with broads?
No, thank you.
Forget the money. Now you got a big estate, you play tennis, he gets up in the morning and goes, do I own anything?
Wait a minute. You can pick on him and you can pick on me, but just because, coming up now, next month, March, I think, 14th, something like that?
Yeah, March 14th, something
like
that,
is your 25th. The silver wedding anniversary,
yes,
right?
Sir. Right, yeah.
Now, that's important. But, you see, sure. But you waited. You see, you didn't get married. You, what, 45, 40, something like that?
Don't get crazy. I wasn't 45.
Why
don't you make me 80, spitting up in the hall?
Well, yeah! You were close to 40. You were 40.
No, I was 38. You know it. You were there every night saying, how old are you?
Why did you wait to 38? Most guys.
Because I hung out with you and him. Both of you were booze.
We're in
Copacabana every night. Every night in New York and Danny's Hideaway. The people you don't know, these are places that are gone now. These people that drank with us are dead. It was just the three of us every night. To anybody.
Yeah. That's right. Bring yourself. I want you in on this, too. You were not exactly, you know.
No,
Father,
I admit
Father
that.
Flanagan
I
in those
admit
days.
That. Father Flanagan?
Girls. Remember, you like girls.
Making a rabbi.
You like girls singers a lot, didn't you? I got it. Hey, over here. Over here, girl singers. Singer. Yeah.
Well, in those days, girl singers, very important.
That's right.
You mention names, you'll be in court again.
I've been in court more than...
laughing like he has no problem.
He's going to be in more court than Raymond Burr. Well, let me tell you.
No, but I got to tell you.
What do you mean you got to tell us? Why do you have to tell us?
Well, because I got it. Because you're my friend. I don't see you that often.
Well,
you know?
I know.
I'm on the standby list.
Well, quit bitching about it.
Quit bitching? It's a new word you use on TV. Anyway, new word, and I can hear a bit. Anyway, but Doc, by the way, I spoke to Johnny.
You're through here.
You're here too long. But I must say that 25 years is great. It really is. And we did it. We made a trip for our 25th anniversary.
You went to the Far East, didn't you?
Yeah. We went to the Far East, went to Asia.
I was there.
I know that.
Yeah.
Is this going to be a test or a little conversation? I know. And all I saw is little Chinese guys walking around. Your shirts are burned. But,
You must have seen more than that.
No, I saw more than that. We went to, I said to the wife. I don't want to be in your
shoes for no money.
Now, you went to Hong Kong?
But let me get my trip out, because well, I'm right. picking on poor Ed.
Well, you keep interrupting it all the time.
Well, of course, that's my job. No, I'm going to let you help me.
All right.
Huh. When did you ever help me? You always sit here and go, he's going right in the dumper, right in the dumper.
Let's hear about the trip. Let's hear about the trip.
25 years we've been friends, and it's been good. It really has. Uh-huh. Oh, you're still on that again.
Anyway, I'll try.
You're the one who wanted to talk about the trip.
Okay, I do.
Get to the trip.
Okay, I'll get to the trip. Let me just let me make a toast, okay?
All right,
don't ever call me 5 minutes before the show.
The king is dead.
Okay. So we started out, Barbara said, and everybody does, I have a wife, that's her name, Barbara said. Barbara said, listen, I'm tired of hearing the stories, you arrange the trip. You want to go away, we have two children, God bless them, I can't handle everything. Right. So you arrange it all. That's the way she talks, I married a Valium. Anyway, except on the wedding night, she went, is that you? But I'll tell you this. Look at this. The guys in the band went, we know her. But I'll tell you this. So we went, John. We left and we flew on Japanese Airlines. Is that what you call it? The Japanese Air? Freddy, you got a minute? Anyway, Freddy's turning around. That's the producer to see if the crowd recognizes him.
Anyway. I suppose it would be Japan Airlines.
Japan Airlines. So Japan Airlines, we went on Japan Airlines and constantly, you know, And marvelous service. I mean, it was 17 hours, the flight to Hong Kong. And that was the first thing. We got in, and the wife said, go to sleep, don't eat, you don't need food, watch the diet, bum, bum, bum. Just have a look. And the guys were bowls of rice, and boom, and I was eating, and she kept saying, you're overdoing it. And she went to sleep. And we flew 17 hours, and every 2 minutes they came over. Darling, they couldn't be nicer. And they kept saying, Mr. Rickles, everything good, everything good. I said, yeah, and I said, when I was a kid, I was going.
I suppose you brought that up to the employees of the airline and make them feel comfortable.
Yes, that's why one person said, "Oh, you don't have to fasten your seatbelt." But they were very nice.
Had you ever been to the Far East before?
When I was 18.
That's right, in the service.
So when we landed in Hong Kong, it was great. It was all little guys running into my stomach. A lot of glasses running around going, oh, I'm sorry. But, and I'm not a tall man, but I felt like, you know, Will Chamberlain. I was, But Hong Kong was great. And then we stayed at the Regency Hotel. Have you been to Regency?
No.
Have you been to Regency?
No, I have not.
Now, both of you probably were at the downtown Dixie. I was at the Regency. That's a classy place.
Well, I suppose it is.
When you're making love to the wife, they come right in the room and go, just continue. You want flowers?
Why, did they think you were dead?
We'll be right back. That was great. That was great.
When you decided to take this trip, does Barbara select where you're going to go, or you just say, choose where you want to go?
She used to. I got to be honest. I come from the school where she became the woman of the house and made all the arrangements and all. And a lot of guys don't do it that way.
Yeah.
They're new hearts. They don't do it that way. Right. Bob goes, Jenny, I think, and she says, keep quiet. Well, we all know Bob. He's not here tonight, unfortunately. He's at home, sitting in his room, humming. But meanwhile, he's a billionaire, as he keeps telling me every day. And I'm very happy for his success.
So you went to Hong Kong. Then
so
you
we went
to
Hong Kong. So what happened was, when we got to Hong Kong... pass it.
Is there more in Hong Kong? Or are we going to be in Hong Kong long and then move along?
No, we're going to take our temperature first.
Oh, I see.
I just went to Hong Kong. I didn't get malaria.
Well, I know that.
So we went to Hong Kong, and we just moseyed around, and we stayed in Kowloon, the Kowloon side. You've never been.
No, I...
I guess you can't afford it.
No, I can afford it.
No, you take Alex to the outskirts of Malibu and say, sweetheart, this is all sand. Now let's get back in the house.
Now, but what I do is I take... Hey, it doesn't matter what it means.
That's right.
That's why I'm here.
That's right. It works, it works. What do you care?
What, does that have a reason?
No, of course
not. The front row button.
So we're in Hong Kong.
In
the Kowloon section.
At the Kowloon section.
Right.
And we took the ferry over and we saw more Chinese people all running around going, Then we went on to Singapore.
Singapore.
And Singapore was great. It's so clean, you can eat off the street, but I didn't try it.
Of course not.
It really is. It's a beautiful city, and we bought some antiques there, and it was wonderful. The food was great. We had, one night, we had, Bob said, let's eat the food of the land. So we had dead eel, a rhino's head, two monkeys that were still alive, and a zebra.
I don't think so.
Well, it was close.
Okay.
And she said, it melts in your mouth. And I stood there, and I thought I was in Mexico, because I kept being a commuter to the John every time.
But you did try some of the local delicacies.
Yeah,
of course.
Sure, I don't make this up. I tell you the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Then we went on to Manila.
Manila
is a great spot. Go there for the summer with your family.
What is it, the charm of Manila?
No, the charm of Manila is they
not
have
Manila.
I'm sorry, not Manila. You have wore that professor hat, but don't go crazy.
You have that New York accent, Manila. It's all right.
All right, Manila, Manila. They know what the hell I'm talking about.
Right.
Don't make it up.
All right, so you're in Manila.
They're not all morons except the front row.
All right. So you're in Manila.
I'm in Manila.
I thought you went to Bangkok.
Well, I changed the trip. Yes, I was in Bangkok, but we're not up to that yet.
Oh, I see. Manila, then to Bangkok.
That's right. Write it down. So now, I went to MacArthur's headquarters. I was in World War II, you were in World War II, and you were in World War II, World War III, World War IV, World War VI, Marine Raiders, and all that baloney with your fighter pilot and blah, blah, blah. And I don't believe you can put a kite on your fanny and fly. Anyway, so we went to Manila, and we went to MacArthur's headquarters.
They keep the headquarters just like they were
just
when he was there?
Just the way it was. How did he live like that? He was a general.
He loved the Philippines. He loved the Philippines.
And I was very intrigued by it, being in World War II. And I was in the Philippines as a young man, you know, but I didn't, you know.
We know your war record. Yeah,
well, I got notes. It was great. Being a Jewish guy, I never did any fighting. I kept saying, here's 300, you attack.
Okay.
Then we went on to Borneo.
Borneo,
great. Borneo, the ship met us with spears.
Yeah.
Now, everybody ran to the dock. Hey, and the captain was out on the deck.
That bad, huh?
Yeah, that bad. Then we went on to... I'm rushing this up because you're only on an hour. It used to be on 15 seconds.
We'll probably miss.
This isn't Germany. I do what I want to do.
Probably,
in Germany, you can do anything. Rip down the wall.
We're probably going to miss Bangkok then, aren't we?
No, we're going to miss Bangkok. Don, but you should visit Bangkok. It's a lot of fun. Flies keep circling.
All right. We'll be right back. Okay. Anyway, Don is going... Stephen Baldwin, who was going to be with us tonight, we've asked him to come back either this week or next week when he can, when his schedule permits. We ran a little long tonight because we were on a trip. Fitzpatrick Travelogue. Remember those?
Yeah.
And as our boat pulls away and our sun sinks slowly. Anyway, Don's going to be at the Golden Nugget starting March 1st for a week, and then at Harrison Lake Tahoe March the 7th. And a happy 25th anniversary.
Thanks,
John. You were on a roll tonight. You were hot tonight.
Oh, thank you.
You were rolling tonight.
Thank you.
Good night.